Hello and a very warm welcome to our coverage of the fourth round of the Porsche Carrera Cup France season. Twinned with the Porsche GT3 Cup Challenge Benelux for this weekend at Le Mans. And we start under the safety car. There's a microclimate here at Le Mans and the weather is not great at all. For now, Mathieu Jaminet is the man who's sweeping all before him in this series. The Martinet by Almirez driver with extraordinary results. And he's on the pole position. Unsurprising, really. He is the strong man in the category. He was 7/10 clear of his main rival, Vincent Beltoise of the Saint-Aloc team. The rookie of the season in the Porsche Super Cup in fantastic form. Jaminet has won every race so far at Barcelona and at Spa and at Zandvoort in this Porsche Carrera Cup France series. Jaminet on pole, Beltoise alongside him on the front row of the grid. And then we have Latour of Sébastien Loeb Racing and another Martinet by Almirez driver, Thomas Laurent. They're on the second row. The Le Mans Bugatti circuit starting under the safety car. The weather conditions are poor here. Number nine there, Geoffrey Denarde and all these drivers. Trying to look after their tyres. They're staying on the slick tyres because they're expecting the track to dry up here. Behind the safety car, we have Jaminet, then Beltoise, then Latour, Laurent, Denarde, Andlauer, Joannem, Lapierre, Roar Lindland, Nicolas Mislin, Frédéric Ancel, and Dylan Dedalé. Well, there's the 20th, Pierre Piron. You've got to be so careful on this slightly damp track. So Piron will now have to start from the back. The end of the first lap under the safety car. You can see the half hour ticking down. And we're going to have a second lap under the safety car. Hopefully that will be it and then we'll be able to get away for the first race of two in the Porsche Carrera Cup France and the Porsche GT3 Cup Challenge Benelux. Well, into the pits and it's Nicolas Mislin. Maybe he wants to change his tyres. He's not the only one coming in. Number 111 as well, that's Thomas Lacour. Well, they're banking on it, the rain getting heavier rather than staying on the slicks and expecting the track to dry. They are switching to the wet weather tyres. Will that choice pay off in strategic terms? Be careful of that wheel. Mislin away again. Another Martinet by Almirez driver. Just like the championship leader, Mathieu Jaminet. And Thomas Laurent, who starts fourth on the grid. Well, there's not lying water on this track and I wonder if Mislin and Lacour may have made a mistake here. It's taking a long time to change these tyres anyway. The mechanic looking rather casual on the left of shot. Go on, get going again. Yeah, there we go. So Lacour, like Miesler, will be at the back. Pierre Piron as well, who we saw spinning when he was following the safety car round. This time, the lights are out on the safety car, so the safety car will be coming in and we'll be able to get some racing now. This will be the wheel start, the first of two races at the Le Mans Bugatti circuit. Warming up the tyres now as they approach the green flag, and it's Mathieu Jaminet, the undisputed championship leader, sweeping all before him this season, winning every race, who has already pulled out a few car lengths away from Vincent Beltoise, with Latour in third position and then Thomas Laurent in fourth. Oh, we've got to watch out for Geoffrey Denada of Sebastian Loeb Racing, the number nine as well. The 85 is Thomas Laurent, and Denada has picked up a position right at the start there. Through La Chapelle for the first time. And Denada has moved into fourth position ahead of Laurent. You see that Laurent has still got his windscreen wiper working overtime, but the others have stopped theirs more or less. Now this is a very good battle. It's at Beltoise and Latour. Latour attacking down the inside, and Latour moves into second for Sebastian Loeb Racing. This is all playing into Mathieu Jaminet's hands. The more his rivals are focused on battling each other, the more he can take advantage of that clear track and pull away at the front. That was impeccable from Florian Latour. Denada attacking again. Beltoise having trouble off the start, and Denada's through and trying to get up as well is Thomas Laurent. Oh, Beltoise has gone backwards. Beltoise now down to fifth position, having started second on the grid. Beltoise, Jaminet's main rival for the title, and he's already lost three spots in the first 4 minutes or so of racing. So Jaminet leading, Latour second. In third position we have Denada, then Laurent, and then Beltoise. And further down the field, we're looking out for the first of the B category drivers. And it was Christophe Lapierre, who's the leader in that category, the 911, and he's currently running in eighth place ahead of Lindland. And there he is, Lapierre, all over the back of Alexandre Joannem. Lindland is the championship leader. He is behind Lapierre at the moment. Jaminet with 131 points. Big lead over the rest. Start finish straight again. A full field of Porsches. And still Mathieu Jaminet leading. Those are the standings after four laps. Number 48 leading from Latour, the 10, and then Donada third in the 9. Beltoise down from 2nd to 5th. That's the big mover in a negative sense. Christophe Lapierre still leading the B category, but racing very serenely at the front is Mathieu Jaminet of Martinet by Almeiras. Stopping, and those who kept their Michelin slicks can think that they made the right decision as Piron is into the pits and getting out of his car. The leader is Mathieu Jaminet. That will come as no surprise to those of you who have followed the whole season with us, the Porsche Carrera Cup. Lapierre Lindland, this in the B category. Lindland, the championship leader. Tom Lacour is in last place after changing his tyres in the pits under safety car, as Donada is now being threatened by Thomas Laurent. Find a way through. Right, Lauren does get past and make it into an excellent afternoon for the Martinet by Almeiras team. Latour, Donada and Laurent. Heavy braking from Laurent there. We had a couple of laps under safety car, of course, at the start of this race. Expect them to complete around about 17 laps in total. Beltoise seems to have settled down now, the man who clocked the second quickest time in qualifying, about 7 tenths down from Mathieu Jaminet. They'll also be on the front row for the second race. In the second qualifying session, they fill the top two spots again. Jaminet and Beltoise. Pierre 7th, Lindland in 8th, Jaminet leading, and he's just posted the fastest lap at a 141.297. His pole position lap was a 139.034. The battle for 3rd is Donada and Laurent, although Beltoise is getting himself involved now, and I think Beltoise fancies his chance of picking up a spot here. Making a little mistake, and now the battle is less Donada and Laurent, it's more Laurent and Beltoise. Into the pits, Nicolas Michelin, who changed onto the wet tyres, now has to come back in to change back to the slicks. A big strategic error from the Martinet by Almeiras man. Oh, problem for Alexandre Joannem. Well, he was 6th on the starting grid. 7th on the starting grid, rather, and he had been going okay. He's running off. The fight continuing. Laurent and Beltoise. Oh, cutting the corner there, Vincent Beltoise. Now coming up back towards Beltoise after his issue on that previous corner. Donada looking much more comfortable in third place now as Thomas Laurent has drifted back from him. Lapping the back marker, the 1-1-1 is Thomas Lacour. Again, Mathieu Jaminet appears to be in a class of his own, and that has been the story throughout 2016. Well, we saw Mislan come in and change from wets to slicks. I think Thomas Lacour is going to have to come in and do the same. This is at Beltoise. Going past Lacour. Just in front of him doing that was Thomas Laurent. All the gaps now, and Jaminet with a 4 second lead over Latour, a further second and a half back to Donada. More grouped up between fourth and sixth. And then still the good battle happening in the B category between Lapierre and Lindland, who aren't giving each other anything. And we can see them just there. Lacour will change onto the slicks. Yep, they were overly cautious with both Mislin and Lacour and changing onto the wet tyres. It didn't work for them, as we see Lapierre and Lindland now. Back for the leadership in the B category, Le Mans Bugatti circuit. A bit more than 12 minutes to go then. And Jaminet is cruising. Pierre Piron already out of the race. Sylvain Noël didn't even take the start. Schwanem unable to get going again either. He's out of the race. This is the gentleman drivers, Lapierre and Lindland. Big braking from the Norwegian Lindland, lots of smoke. Full width of this circuit. A little bit of rain fell on those curbs, but not so much that it's going to make you slip. It's the battle for seventh, but it's the battle for the leadership in the B category, the gentleman drivers. Flash the lights, it's often to try to intimidate those around them. We saw it from Latour, Donada as well. Usually it's in vain. The 7, Beltoise behind the 85, Thomas Laurent, the battle for 4th. Beltoise really messing up off the start. Dropping from 2nd to 5th, there are the flashing lights again from Beltoise. Letting Laurent know that he's there. Laurent defending his position. Beltoise looking handily placed here, getting himself into Laurent's slipstream. Laurent has every right to defend his position, and he's doing so well thus far, but there's still a long way to go here. 10 minutes is a long time to hold off someone who's looking as threatening as Vincent Beltoise. I wonder if this little tussle might just help out Julian Andlauer, who is currently running in sixth position. Will it become a three-way fight for fourth? We can see Andlauer there, just briefly coming into shot. Ooh, slid a bit there. And now into the slipstream. This is looking interesting for Beltoise. Beltoise making his move. Beltoise getting into the inside, coming through the start-finish straight. And Beltoise into fourth, having started second on the grid. At least he's managed to pick up that position. He dropped to fifth very quickly, but he's now back up to fourth. 8 minutes from the end, and Beltoise overtaking Thomas Laurent. The Saint-Alloc man through at the expense of the Martinet Bayal-Miras driver. Impeccable. No contact between the two cars. And Andlauer, the 5-5-5 now, fancies his chances. Oh dear, oh dear, Andlauer's got that wrong. Overly aggressive, it just wasn't there for him. Andlauer has come out worse there compared to Thomas Laurent. We see it again. Losing it on the corner. Thomas Laurent, still fifth, but behind him, it's that battle for the gentleman driver's honours, and it's still Christophe Lapierre holding off his Sebastian Loeb Racing teammate, Roar Lindland, the Norwegian. Battle intensifying between Lapierre and Lindland. Lindland attacking. Lapierre has the inside line. And now Lindland trying to dive to the inside. He's going to have the black flag for Sylvain Noël. Ooh. Looks like a puncture there for Andlauer. Oh, the car bashed up after the collision with Thomas Laurent. He was overly hasty. I think he could have bided his time a bit and then had a crack. You see the flags of Racing Catalans in the background, French rugby champions. Going so well on his first race on the Sunday, Mathieu Jaminet. We've hardly seen him in this race, we haven't had to. He's so far clear. Jaminet, the fastest in both qualifying sessions. He's posted the fastest lap in this race, and he's been leading from the start. Ooh, and that was Lindland going through past Lapierre. Lapierre went very wide. a change in the B category leadership then. After a little contact between the two rivals. Beltoise having a much better second half of the race than the first half. And he is now right up on the exhaust pipe of Geoffrey Dinarde, running third in this race behind Latour and Jaminet. Beltoise attacking. Beltoise going one way, then the other. Contact between Beltoise and Dinarde. And Beltoise, can he hold on to this? They're side by side. Oh, Dinarde's got the inside line. Beltoise going briefly off the track. Another bit of contact. And Dinarde holds third as the back markers move out of the way. That was the 171 of Thierry Ligo. Important to try to use the traffic to your advantage when you're trying to make up ground and make up positions. Dinarde and Beltoise flashing those headlights again is Beltoise. Beltoise, who stood third in the championship coming into this round. 10 points behind Dinarde. Jaminet on 131, Dinarde 96, Beltoise 86. Latour 74 in the gentleman drivers. Lindland with 114, Lapierre 109. They're the two to watch for. Beltoise hoping to get something on the Musée corner. Not happening. Needs to be patient here, Vincent Beltoise. Don't want to do what Andlauer did on Laurent. The time is running out if Beltoise is to make his move. Beltoise on another attack. Dinarde holding. Great fight. Well, now Beltoise. Oh, he's gone wide though on the exit. And Dinarde reclaims the position. Wonderful, wonderful duel. Dinarde knew that Beltoise would try to dive to the inside, shut off that route. More back markers. Beltoise still in the slipstream of Geoffrey Dinarde. The top two positions are decided. Third is still up for grabs. Jaminet will win. Latour will finish second. Beltoise attempt to make it three different teams represented on the podium. Latour and Dinarde are both Sebastian Loeb Racing. Beltoise attacks again, diving to the inside. Dinarde briefly over the grass. And Dinarde looking like he's going to hold again. These are the moments of maximum tension for Geoffrey Dinarde and Vincent Beltoise. The half an hour is up. When they cross the line again, there'll be one lap to go. Beltoise has to do it on this lap. He's got about a minute and 40 for it to happen. Oh, we might need a mistake from Donada to allow Beltoise through. Well defended by Donada. Well, they're fighting it out for third in this race, but also second overall in the championship. It's Mathieu Jaminet who is going to take the checkered flag. He's taken every race win this season. This will be his seventh victory in 2016 in the Porsche Carrera Cup France. And we're still interested in who will finish third here. The checkered flag. And Mathieu Jaminet with the win. Second, going to Florian Latour. A gap of over 11 seconds. And third for Donada. Beltoise fourth. Laurent fifth. Oh, and coming across the line, is it Lapierre or Lindland getting the position in the gentleman's category? And did cross the line before Lapierre, but was penalised because of the contact coming through to take over first place. So Lapierre would end up having the B category win. There's the winner, Mathieu Jaminet.
Bon, Mathieu, une
start to finish for him. Seventh win in seven races.
Pas forcément une course facile avec des conditions particulièrement piégeuses au départ.
Voilà exactement, conditions piégeuses au départ, c'était un peu humide avec un peu de pluie. Quand on est leader, c'est jamais facile. J'ouvre la marche, donc peut-être je roule sur un faux rythme, je ne prends pas trop de risques.
I didn't take too many risks.
Ça suit bien, mais ils n'étaient pas en mesure de m'attaquer.
I saw they were following me, but unable to attack me. I accelerated a little bit in the mid-race and built up a lead, and then I just tried to control it through to the end and paid attention to the back markers.
Avec cette grille en 2-2 décalé qu'on n'a pas l'habitude de voir, c'est pas forcément facile pour vous de vous adapter entre le 1-1 décalé et le 2-2 décalé.
Ouais, c'est un peu particulier. Là, c'est bien qu'on soit parti du safety car. Different, après, je pense,
and we came up behind the safety car.
À voir, parce que le premier virage est assez rapide et ça se referme sur une chicane assez lente.
The first corner
donc à voir
is quick.
Deux, mais j'ai peur qu'il y ait un accrochage.
We'll
pas
see what happens in race 2 with a more
Merci
classic
Mathieu.
Grid, and I'm worried there'll be contact. So, Jaminet confirmed with his seventh win out of seven. Latour, Donada, Beltoise, Laurent. And as I said, it's Lapierre winning the B category ahead of Roar Lindland after a decision. First to go.